Good morning, everyone. You know, between the condition of the state, the New Hampshire primary, and more, you might have missed the condition of the city. Well, Rick Clark is the city manager of Des Moines, and Rick, thanks for coming in today.
Happy to be here.
We're talk about the condition of the city, because you gave the condition of the city address here last week. Overall, how are we doing? What's the condition of Des Moines?
You know, actually, Kevin, we're doing really well. In fact, if you look over the last 2 years, the city of Des Moines has gotten really wonderful accolades from a whole series of national publications. The ones that I like best were delivered by Forbes magazine, and they talked about Des Moines being a great place to raise a family, a great place for young professionals, a great place for business. And we had, I think, over the last 24 months, about 30 different publications that said...
You made some pretty impressive lists.
Really. And it's great. And it sort of adds to the buzz in the community. And frankly, I see our own citizens feeling good about Des Moines as well.
But when you gave this address, you also listed a number of challenges. And the very first one that you listed was basically money, budget. And there are some big challenges that Des Moines and probably every other city faces. Tell me what the problems are. There's obviously not enough money to do as much as we would like to do or should do.
Well, here's the thing, and it's important to say this, I think, to begin that point. The first thing that I want people to know is our mayor and council have done really a wonderful job in managing budgets. And when you look at some of the markers that are traditional, like bond ratings, we have a AAA bond rating. That's pretty remarkable for a city in the Midwest to maintain a AAA bond rating when we have all the issues we have. We have great credit ratings, we have markers, we have adequate reserve funds, not extensive, but they're sufficient for us. So in terms of managing our funds, the mayor and council have done a really nice job of that. But there are some issues we have to overcome, and in order to understand it, people need to know this. Over the last 6 years or so, we have cut about $28 million out of our general fund budget. That's about 18% of all the money we collect in for our general fund, about 18% in expense reductions. We've eliminated over 300 positions in city government. So we've done a lot of really heavy lifting to make sure that our revenues and our expenses match. And we're sort of getting to the point that if further reductions occur, it's really going to require some reductions in expenses that I'm just concerned the people won't like.
Well, so how do you go about creating a balance, correcting that particular issue? In other words, I mean, are you talking about raising taxes? Because as property tax values fall, or property values fall, so does the revenue that you can get in the next couple of years.
Well, there is a proposal to have a very modest increase in the tax rate here. But quite frankly, I think the mayor and council feel, and I think this is a reflection of the community, there's only so far you can go in increasing taxes. We have a population here in Des Moines which is, you know, they're hardworking people. They don't make a huge amount of money for the most part. So there's only so far you can go in increasing taxes and still have this be an affordable community, which is what we want. There's going to have to be some adjustment there. I'm just afraid that unless we introduce other revenues for city government, that we're going to be left with very few options.
Well, tell us what you're talking about when you talk about other revenues.
Well, understand that the way state law is set up in Iowa, the legislature, state government, really controls the kind of revenues that we can raise as a city. So when you look at what's legally permissible today, the only real legally permissible revenue that we could access that we don't have today is a sales tax.
A municipal sales tax.
Yes, it's a 1 cent local option sales tax. In fact, most of the state of Iowa, most of the cities in Iowa have a local option sales tax. We don't have it here. It could be introduced. It requires a referendum of the people. We've tried in the past. It's hard to get. But maybe with the right proposition, maybe our folks would think that there is justification to do it now.
And you said that would raise you had estimated in the neighborhood of $20, $30 million?
Yeah, somewhere $24 to $28 million, depending on the actual numbers. But that's one example, Kevin. That's allowable under law. In theory, there's other things that we could do. You could increase the hotel motel tax, increase the franchise fee.
Would you like to see the state government perhaps make some changes that would allow for some other revenues?
That's really it. I think what we're looking for here is to have a partnership with the state to say, look, the governor and the legislature seem to be intent on looking for ways to reduce commercial taxes. That would be very harmful to us in the current environment. So if we're going to look at that, then what we need is some help from the legislature to say, look, here are some other options, cities, that you could utilize to generate some additional revenues to offset the losses on the commercial side.
All right. Rick Clark is our guest at Newsmaker this week. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back with more on the condition of the city.